Hello, I'm David. In this video I will show you how to connect USB charger to XR400. You can connect any low power 12 volts DC device this way. At first we need to demount the lamp to have access to the electrical harness. Now you should see something like this. We are looking for the connector on the left side. After removing electrical tape, we can see a 4-pin connector. It leads to a small voltage regulator with an external capacitor. There is one nut holding it in place. We need to unscrew it and remove the voltage regulator. We want to add an additional 2-pin connector to draw 12 volts DC from the regulator. Keep in mind that XR has small power coil, so you can't draw too much current from it. I used this phone holder and charger for 1 year without any problem in my XR, so it works. Now I need 12 volts DC for the same phone charger, but also I need to power up this small computer. There should be more about this computer and about my new fairing in future videos, but now let's get back to work. I'm using waterproof electrical connector. You can buy it at AliExpress. I marked this wire. It should be plus 12 volts DC. Second one is ground. First we unwrap tape to get access to the wires. Now I get rid of the plastic cover. Let's check those wires now. You can see their AC input and DC output. Red and yellow wires are AC input to the voltage regulator. DC output is green and black wire. Black wire is plus 12 volts DC and green wire is ground. Now I cut isolation to get access to the copper wire. Be careful to not damage the copper core. There is same story with the black wire. I think it is good idea to make a small offset between those extra connections. Next, I trim new wires from the additional connector. Now I remove insulation from the both wires. Everything looks fine, so I can temporarily attach new wires to the old wires. Before soldering, I cut off this extra copper wire. I use some rosin and later I solder this to make proper connection. Here you can see results after soldering. Next I add a small piece of hard rubber and secure it using an electrical tape. I do same with the second wire. I add more electrical tape and at the end I wrap it using fabric tape. My new voltage regulator with 12 volts DC plug looks nice. Let's install it now and check it on the bike. we need to place it back and secure it using the nut. We connect voltage regulator like before and add more fabric tape to secure everything. After securing it with tape, we can start the bike and check it using voltmeter. I connected my multimeter to the new connector. As you see, multimeter detects constant voltage and the value is 14.6 volts. So everything is fine. Voltage is constant while I add throttle. That's nice and it works as it should. Now it's time for my new windshield. I've made it last time by myself. Similar one will be in DR2. It is mounted to the handlebar, so it is pretty universal. Now I connect my phone charger and computer to the new 12V DC outlet. After a long assembly, you can see the results. USB charger is sealed with rubber cap, so it should survive the rain. This charger is from AliExpress. You probably can recognize it as it looks similar to the RAM X-Grip mount, but this one cost only $10. I forgot about most important part. Now it looks much better. Let's test it. I hope you can see phone charging indicator. I can also control voltage in this computer. When I connect charger to the phone, you can see charging screen notification. Well done, I hope you like it. Thanks for watching and see you next time.